No matter how the dark night, in the morning, joy will come. A tutor is someone who allows you to see the higher part of yourself when sometimes it becomes hidden to your own view. I now call Dr. S. Malathi Ma'am, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, to introduce the chief guest of this afternoon session.
Introduce our chief guest, Dr. Srinivasan Narayan, Faculty of Mechanical Engineering at VIT University. He completed his UG degree in Jayaram College of Engineering and Technology, UG
at Anna University, Guindy campus. From 2010 to 2016, he completed his PhD at Indian Institute of Technology, Mumbai, and Monash University, Australia, Melbourne, with 8.25 CGPA. After his PhD, his academic research, he has an institute postdoctoral fellow in Indian Institute of Technology, Chennai, at the Department of Metallurgical and Materials Engineering, and he has published more than 20 reputed journals and many conferences in various places, including Greece. He completed more experimental exercises, including 7.5 years of experience in operating and data analysis with Bhabha Atomic Research Center, Trombi, and IIT Chennai. He organized more number of workshops and FDPs in various places, including Germany and Pune. He completed the certificate course in advanced manufacturing process analysis and protecting the world, introducing corrosion science and engineering. He has R&D experience with fabrication of additive manufacturer wheel center for using generative design Autodesk for the amount of 1,48,578 rupees on 2020. And on 2019, with Mahindra and Mahindra Company for the R&D project for the amount 75,000. Without consuming any time, I would like to hand over the session to our chief guest, Dr. Srinivasan Narayanan, to enlighten this session. Welcome, sir.
Yes, ma'am. May I audible?
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir.
Yeah. Could you give me the permission so that I can share my screen?
Of course, sir.
We must grant permission in order to screen share. Hello.
Of course, sir, you can, sir.
No, I am not able to share the screen. Can't share your screen. You must grant permission.
Sir, your camera is on. Can you log in with the second ID, sir?
Second ID?
Yes, sir. In which you are going to present the screen, sir.
No, you must give me the permission. You must give me the this share screen. No, you must grant me the permission.
Sir, it is already allowed, sir. Sir, we cannot share the screen when the camera is on, sir.
No, it's not like that. I'm logging in some other ID. Can you just accept this?
Yes, sir. We are accepting the invites, sir.
who is the host? I mean, host has to give me the permission to rent a script. You can talk to Reynold. Reynold, he might be able to guide you. Ma'am?
Sir,
சார் எனக்கு கேமரா ஆன் பண்ணியிருந்தா ஸ்கிரீன்ஷாட் பண்ண முடியாதா? நீங்க சொல்லுங்க சார்.
எஸ் சார், கேமரா ஆன்ல இருந்துச்சுன்னா ஸ்கிரீன்ஷாட் பண்ண முடியாது சார். சேம் மெயில் ஐடியில லேப்டாப்ல இல்லை கம்ப்யூட்டர்ல உங்க ஸ்கிரீனை ப்ரெசென்ட் பண்ணுங்க சார். So what happened, sir? Sir?
ஓகே சார், பண்ணா எப்போ அடிக்கிறது வேணும்? சீனு ஜிஜி சார், ஜிலிங் நம்ம மொசில்லா பேரண்ட்ஸ்.
Hello ma'am, this is Reynold. Can you permit Srinivasan sir one second? Na?
Yes sir.
Yeah, he is trying to join. Can you allow him?
Yes sir, we are allowing all invites sir.
Yes ma'am, I inform.
Thank you.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, you are audible and the presentation
actually,
is
ready. Actually, I did not get the code properly. I was trying to log in with some other ID. So it's not that camera and presentation. I can do it both. Presentation on and camera also.
Okay, sir.
So is my screen visible?
Yes, sir, your screen is visible.
So, shall I start, madam?
Yes, sir, of course. You can start, sir.
Okay, let's start in a formal way and many thanks for the introduction. Today we are going to see TRIZ and design thinking. TRIZ technique and design thinking. Actually, when we combine both techniques, there is a chances of innovation, invention, and so on, and the solution to the industry problem is possible. Then how long do I have time?
Yes, sir.
How long do I have time?
Till 3:30, sir.
Okay, thank you. Any Q&A session after that?
Yes, sir, of course.
Okay, so I can take you 3:30. Okay. Thank you. So, let's see what is about TRIZ first. So, TRIZ is, from Russia, okay. Like Six Sigma, it's very famous and it's a process-oriented technique. It's very famous because everybody talks about Six Sigma. And it has enjoyed its a lot of attention and welcome by all academicians and researchers. But unlike Six Sigma, it's another concept that helps you to have thinking laterally. Okay, it increases your understanding of the problem better. That is TRIZ. What is TRIZ? TRIZ is a Russian equivalent way of inventing problem solving. Okay. So Dr. Altschuler and his student has implemented this term of TRIZ after reading a lot of patents, granted patents and solved problems. Okay. So it is simply TRIZ is nothing but encouraging you to have multitude lateral thinking, problem solving techniques. And that you can do thinking about all of these are it's possible with the help of TRIZ. And it is based on two principles. First one is somebody, some people, somewhere. Has already solved the problem or the one that is similar to you. So our job as a TRIZ master, our job is to go and find that solution and bring it in the industry that is in our current problem. So it is I'm by education I am a mechanical engineer. Okay, by academically, I am a mechanical engineer, so I should not close my eyes, I should not close my thinking that I work only on academic related to mechanically. If possible, the language department can help me if I am working on certain project that requires them. So it's like I am a civil engineer or I am an electronics engineer, whoever it is, okay. Let us have the innovative solutions come from different directions and acting across all the barriers. That's what it is. So this, you go and find out the solution constantly. Go and find out the solution constantly for your problem. Generally as an engineer's job is to solve the problem of the society. So that the life of the people get it is simplified and makes very comfortable. That's the role of the engineer. That's the maximum role of the engineer. So we have problem statements and we have problem, we encounter the problem in household activities as well as in the some industry. Okay. And we have a lot of industry known problems that we are solving. So TRIZ, what is the role of TRIZ?
how can this can help? In the case of industrial oriented problem, we can get help of TRIST. We have TRIST toolkits. We have a lot of TRIST toolkits. If these toolkits are properly applied, you can have the solutions. And this is iterative in nature. So don't be happy, don't be satisfied with what you get, what is the solution. You constantly apply the TRIST, constantly apply, constantly questioning, don't satisfy, and constantly ask the questions so that TRIST technique can better apply. Okay. So I said first is somebody, somewhere, some people are working on, have already solved the problem similar to the area that we are working on. So creativity means finding that and adapt in our premises, adapt in our situation. That's the one. Second one is lateral thinking. That is the second approach to the lateral thinking. Okay. So don't accept contradictions, resolve them. What is that? See, contradictions means, as I said earlier, we have the problem, we have some industrial problem, and as an engineer or as a graduate of computer science or electrical electronics, we are bound to solve that. We make an attempt to find a solution for that problem. Okay, so in this process, we will come up with certain solutions. So this iterative solution. So in that, in this solution, we may be in the process of bringing some unwanted or uninvited inconveniences. So that is called contradictions. Don't be satisfied with that contradictions. Try to apply the concept. We have a lot of TRIST toolkits. Don't accept these contradictions. Try to resolve, try to improve, try to iterate. So for example, I can say the everyday examples of TRIST. Okay. For example, the email spam filter, email Google or Gmail spam filter, okay, and then the tower, mobile tower. So these are all the everyday examples of TRIST, and the airbags, okay, the enemy drive in the car. The catastrophe usually happens, high impact, sudden impact, low, hitting, so that's why we need a lot of, data. So for that, airbags, properly oriented. So all these things are everyday examples of similarly cell phone signal tower. All these things are examples of TRIST. Okay. Don't accept all this is the problem, this is the solution. So these solutions, in natural activity, don't accept the solutions. Solutions come with certain inconveniences. Okay, don't be happy with that, try to resolve. So constantly apply the techniques of TRIST, that's it. So we call TRIST champion, TRIST master, it's a perfect problem solving tool, okay? So that the engineers, the stakeholders, people in the ecosystem, they will be happy in solving the problem. What are the TRIST kit that offers solution for the problem? So we should know what kit we need to take out, what the solution methodology that we need to take. Sometimes we take up this guy, sometimes we take up this 40 principles
that's most common. People are now getting more than 40 principles, but academically it is very much acceptable, and it is there. 40 principles acceptable, time scale and ideology and separation principle, resources, contradiction matrix. So these are TRIST toolkit. This is separate 3-credit course, so 1 hour is very difficult to cover an entire course, but whatever is possible, so that the takeaway message can be very clear for you guys who are listening. Okay, and we have TRIST 40, that website is still working on. The recent happenings about TRIST is possible, okay, by exploring this website. So we said a lot of to just do its relevant. Let us see the diffuse Tatane into Tatane features, that is contraction matrix, and then 40 inventory principles. So in contraction matrix, okay, contraction matrix, we have, you know, so 1 to 39, 39 into 1 to 39, 1 x scale of weight of the moving object, 2 top, you know, relating to weight of the stationary object, 3 length of the moving object, like that, we have 39 into 39 features. Okay, so whatever the, however the complex of engineering problem, this gets solved, okay, by either increase or decrease. Okay, increase certain aspect or decrease certain aspect. For example, I'm a mechanical engineer, so I can talk very more of mechanical side. For example, strength and ductility is always a negative correlation. Similarly, strength and hardness is always a positive correlation. So like that, there's a correlation also do exist. So it's very interesting to solve it. So either increase the weight or decrease the weight, increase the length or decrease the length, and the object is stationary or moving. Okay, so these are the combinations we can solve. Okay, for example, moving objects which can easily change the position in the space, either on their own, this is the directional forces. Okay, so these are explanation offered. I think we can read it out. Okay, so what is very important is contraction matrix is built, you know, based on we want certain features, you know, to improve certain features to decrease or worsen. For example, I want to get good grades, that's improvement. Okay, so in order to get good grades, I need to worsen. I need to worsen the area that I don't understand. Okay, so that area has to narrow down. So certain aspects, so my rate has to get improved. And for that, certain features I should get worse than them. So all these things, this combination will help, you know, to arrive, to reach the solution. Of course, it's not the permanent and one-time single solution. It's a continuous effort. You need to have a constant quest or thirst to apply the, you know, tools of techniques of TRIZ so that ideal solution can be found. Any doubts up to this? Any doubts? Ma'am, any doubts up to this? Okay. So I'm so 40, another important aspect here, one of the two, and 40, it's 40 inventory principle. So this number is same, one means segmentation. So wherever you talk to any TRIZ master, TRIZ champion, the numbers is same. So if I 12 means it's equal potentiality everywhere. So the number will not change. But nowadays, I have heard that people have increased this 40 inventory principle. Some other number, 43 or 49, but I'm not sure. And this is the 41 is globally accepted even now. Wherever you go to any academic books, research, you know, journal articles, only this 40 inventory principle is there. But let us see, very few, that is very important to understand. Okay. So, for example, separation. Separation is separation is one of the thing that is separation is taking out, okay, either stick out or separation principle. So separation means, for example, I will tell you the situation. I want my room, you know, air conditioning has to be very good, okay, it has to be conditioned in my air, and the temperature everything has to be I need to maintain 24 or 23 whatever source. But at the same time, the AC that is fitted, you know, here or next to my room, it's making noise, you know, it's making noise and it's noisy and I'm not able to concentrate. Okay. So, this is the my situation. Point number two, I wanted to have, you know, compressed air, okay, for my industry or for my household. I need to have it. At the same time, that is making me noise. So, So okay, I want to have a good thing that is from the device. The bad thing I don't want. That's a good worsening and then improving features. So we have two features available. So what if the output unit of the AC air conditioner unit, what if the output of the physical pressure, physical this compressor is kept out somewhere else, and then let us have only the input, their output, whatever. If it is air compressor, that means it's a compressed air. If it is air conditioner, means it is the air which is of conditioned air, 24 or 23. So that's what is for that we need to separate this noise making instruments, take it out and place it somewhere else, and then put it into the pipe connections, and then let us have enough enjoy without any problem. You may think this is we can live with that, no problem. We can live with these connections, no problem. But what if the silences or the noise is very much important, maintaining this, I mean, noise-free atmosphere is very much important. Then, in the case of hospitals, in the case of theaters, this is, ambience is very important. Maybe less, significance for our household or industry. But if it is for a hospital industry, at the theater or the near the mall, so again, what is the problem? Again, what is the problem? The problem is, you need to conduct the air, okay? The air has to flow from one place to another place, and there are losses associated with this. So efficiency of the system gets decreased or compromised. So how do we take care? That is also another aspect. So instead of the AC, let us have this window, this outlet, okay? The noise making instrument separated out from the interfering part. That's called the interfering part. Or that is disturbing. I just want. Similarly, the burger, say this burglar alarm or this dog barking system. Don't have to maintain a dog. No, it's, just have this burglar dog alarm. So see, this is just thinking out of the box. Just any curious, if you have that thinking. I'm not telling this is the only solution. Separate it out wherever it's possible. No. Depends upon the cost, depends upon the situation. Look, these are the solutions available. If you want, take it. So that's the, you know, attitude, that is the, you know, idea behind this application of this. Okay. So we usually need only a part of the system or some property features. Okay. So we need light, not a lighting device. Okay. So like that, there are, you know, we need a vacuum cleaner. No, we do not need a vacuum cleaner as such, but we need a cleaning capacity. Okay. So have some nozzles, unfitted nozzles, but conduction is so. So nozzles in dirt parts are unfitted where they don't necessarily need them. So just separate it out. What is not needed or what is creating a disturbance? Uninvited, okay. Disturbance. Just separate it out. That's the principle of separation. Put a noise air conditioning compressor outside the building and pipe the connections. Here we have this problem. The pipe connections, the losses efficiency may be a problem. So try to work it out. That's it. Have some insulation. That's it. Another important aspect, merging and consolidation. Okay. Bring closer together or merge identically a similar object or operations in space. Automatic refill machine learning, multi plug-in cartridge, okay. So multi-blade razors. So this multi-blade razors, okay, this is a combination or consolidation of two or three blades merging together, or the effort will be very less, okay, because we have so many separate small units built together that takes care of the purpose of this razor. By copulence, object operations continuous or parallel, bringing them together on time. Okay. Fourier analysis also another example, integration of many cycles. Okay. Pipeline computer processors perform different stages in calculations simultaneously. Right? So this is another aspect that we can we appreciate. Okay. That you know, consultant is a painter. So instead of painting with one roller, he has the multiple, the merged consolidator, and he just dip another paint. So that the large area can be covered at the lesser effort. After this, any doubt? Is the screen visible and am I audible? No problem, right? Ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so screen is visible, right? And am I audible? No problem.
It's visible and your audio is clear.
Okay, thank you. So this is the aspect of merging and consolidation. Okay. So when and then another aspect, universality. What is universal? One device, you know, doing multi-purpose. For example, I have in my office, I have a printer, and a photocopier, and the fax machine, scanner, everything at one place. At you know, all these functionalities are integrated and provided in the single unit. So the child's car safety, seat cover, the pusher, Swiss Army knife. So it has a multi-purpose Army knife. Okay. So make an object perform multiple functions, eliminate the need for other parts or even other material, other products. Okay. So grill in a microwave oven is the another example. And this this is so babysitter or mother, for her, she does not need so many items, the figure which is presented on the left side, she has to have so many items, in order to pamper babysitting her, But when you have this, the right hand side, nowadays last two or three decades, we have, the purpose is, we have multi-purpose, for a single product or single service. That's it. So, and another concept, nested dog. This concept of nested dog and their impact, it's really, really fantastic. Imagine, we need to transport a material. We need to transport tons of material from one place to another place. So, think of the cargo usage. Okay, or the cargo, or the ship, or the the flights. Okay, you think of that. The how much CO2 emission of all these things. So what is nested dog? We might have played during our childhood. Nested dog is nothing but a utilization of space properly. Okay, if possible, all are if possible, the conditions do apply. Okay. Putting a bigger object, putting a smaller object into the bigger object. Okay, putting a bigger object into the putting a smaller object into the bigger object in ascending or descending way. So in this way, we can have lot of things to put together, and it occupies very less space. Okay, very less space. And this concept nested dog, it's applied even the ship or hull tanker. Okay, place one object inside the other. Okay, so we need to have some hollow has to be there. So place each object in turn, inside the other, so that you can transport. How I can relate this, it's useful for the transportation industry, logistics and transportation industry. It has a great impact because the CO2 emission will be less for the shipment. Two or three ships will be able to reduce to one ship. Provided if you have the design is in such a way, or the material or the final product is in such a way that it accommodate the concept of mystery. Make one part possible to carry another part. So they should have a cavity, or they should have no material. So we can have a lot of jargons, engineering jargon, cavity, no material. So the name of this principle comes from the Russian folk art called whatever the name, which series of wooden dolls are nested one inside the other. It's a double hull in oil. Even now, people are working in the merchant, industry of merchant navy, they will be able to appreciate this, the purpose of double hull in oil tankers, because this will reduce the potential for possible the leakage to the these chemicals, explosives, unnecessary leakages. So that's why double hull is provided. That's also the concept of message. This telescoping structure, umbrella, or the blind man stick, so all these things are example of this double. Wherever possible, just take it down, and it's wherever it's not needed, just pull it down and put it in the your back. It's easy to carry. Okay. So this is the concept of nested doll, placing the bigger object, placing the smaller object with the bigger one, and in the ascending fashion or descending fashion. Okay. Single hull, oil cargo, outer skin is protected by two pads, and it is this protects environment by say just one more added layer of security. It's like two-factor identification, one more added layer of security so that it does not leak, because the consequences are very dangerous. Consequences cannot be imagined. Okay. And this is another concept that the teacher is able to teach. The stick or the blind man stick concepts are the same thing, and after the lecture she can put it down, she can bring it down and make it she can walk around to the sea. And another point is cushion in advance. What is that cushion in advance? Before any untoward event happens, okay, we think in advance. If anything happens, what is the plan B? Okay. So that's the concept of cushion in advance. The emergency means beforehand to compensate for the low relative object. Okay. Multi-channel control system, airbag in the car, spare wheel, battery backup. Now, see, there's a part that and I can plug in my phone, and at least I can talk to you guys my Android mobile or Apple phone with the power bank. Okay, that's also one of the multi-channel control system, back, in the past, another spare wheel located in the two-wheeler or the four-wheeler. Pressure relief valve. This pressure relief valve releases its pressure and save the surrounding, save the team. Okay, otherwise there will be explosion. Imagine explosion happens in thermal or plants. Imagine explosion happens in even in our home, whenever we cook, we see the silver and aluminium-based cooker, you just imagine this closed system and pressure gets built up because of the temperature, and if it's suddenly explosion, this happens in our household, our mother and sister, genies are also cooking. So, think, the impact. So that's why we have pressure relief valve. Emergency lighting circuit, automatic safe operations performed in computer control servers. We can call this is another Popayaka concept as well. Okay. Simple technique and gas very useful. This is also a Popayaka technique. There's just every 5 candidates, the wherever I work in the MS office, MS related files, and then auto save. Okay, automatic save operations. Or if there is a sudden abrupt power disconnect shutdown, it will save automatically. So these things are pushing in advance as well as Popeye concept as well. Crash barriers on water ice. That's don't be any magnetic barrier system. So this is the example where you can appreciate concept. So pushing in advance. And another this one. So, multi-channel, you don't have to waste, and whatever the spillage gets collected without any disturbance, and it's optimally utilized without any wastage. That's it. And even potentially, so not that has to be raised or lower. Imagine 5-10 object has to be raised. Any object or the vehicle, it has to be raised or lower. So you need to have, you need to push, you need to do, effort, you need to do some, load, and this consumes, okay, cost, this labor and everything, you know, associated problems. So how can we address this? So the need to raise or lower the ceiling limit are performed by anywhere. So if you want to do something about the object, okay, and that is very difficult or this consumes time, money and everything, it consumes resources unnecessarily, think about the environment. And if anything happens to the environment, think about the object. So this part is like that, okay. So again, I'm telling you, this is not the permanent fixed solution of this application of this. This is the trial and error, continuous application of problem solving techniques. Okay, it's not like our regular academic 120 megapascal means 120 megapascal line to achieve. It's not analytical, it is more of trial and error based on experience. Okay, and the cost also is involved. Okay, not always suitable techniques, suitable algorithm, suitable optimization. We have cost, you know, comforts. Okay. We should have whatever we want, we should have comfort on spending money. So all aspects should get considered. That's very important aspect. Catalogs, spring-loaded parts delivery system in the factory. Mechanics pit. What is a mechanic pit? You'll be able to understand now. Place a heavy object on ice and let it ice minutes on low end. Okay. Angle, coastline, changes in gravitational potential, utilize the environment that you want to use. Descending cable cars, balance with the descending cars. Okay. So if you want to lift a heavy object, instead of this, the labor will be very less, labor, time, consumption, energy. So fatigue also is very important. Fatigue. Okay. So this, okay. So yes, to lift a heavy object, and it is taking this design, so maybe like this. Gradually, let us slow it down or coming down. Okay. This is what I was talking about, this mechanics. See, I have a heavy object, okay, and it has to get lifted out. Okay, I mean, I need to lift this leg. So for that, the pneumatics or hydraulics based system is needed and it consumes energy. So instead, don't stage the object. Play something with the environment. Environment is dig out, you know, just pit, mechanics pit. That's it. You can be, we have seen, you know, in the Nadaran, we have seen, we might have seen this arrangement. But of course, not always this is the way. So, whenever for manufacturing, all these automobile, you know, parts in the future, is it all this any of the automobile assembly line? Something we need to lift that is needed. Okay, whenever we go there and see the checking on our. Not always this is great. Okay. The environment situation permits. So it is have thinking a lot, you know, inviting solutions. That's why Chris and design thinking, you guys have combined. Design thinking also, let's get an invitation from, let's get an invitation, let's get suggestions from different people, all the people. Okay, that's the another thing we will come to. So another dimension, what is that? Utilize the dimension, utilize the space. So what is that? These two guys are there. They are enjoying, you know, staying in the past. Okay. And they have a problem. What is the problem? These cows are, you know, these sheep, these animals come, okay, and disturbing them. Okay, disturbing them, their droppings and disturbing their peace. Okay. So what they thought, they thought they don't want to have this disturbance. So that's why they built a wall. Okay. They built a wall, but after built the wall, they realized it has got disturbed their view. You know, in the fine, the evening with a cup of coffee, they cannot enjoy the view. Okay, because it is obstructing because of the wall. So instead, if these guys are Chris expert as Chris master, they have come to know the concept of Chris. Okay, they might have enjoyed it without, they might have enjoyed their view without these disturbances. Okay, these animal disturbances. How? So just build a wall. Build a wall near or whatever, and make a slope so that these animals cannot jump. Of course, the cost associated also matters. The building wall and then this fencing, all just, you know, just a flash of thoughts. That's it. This encourages you to have different dimensions. I mean, you know, all the suggestions, solutions. And then this one, okay, utilize the space in its direction and, you know, y direction. Okay, utilize the space. Move into additional dimension and move from one to another. Coil, telephone wire, the curve, bristles or another. Pizza box, spiral staircases, which is less flowing area. So all are, you know, exempt for another dimension. Introduction of down and up slopes between the stations or another. Reduce core power. Stacked or multi-layered centrifugal board, multi-car parks, multi-story car parks, you know, based vertical office blocks. And so on, it will go on and down. I will rush it now because I have very few time. Listening this case, what is that? See, this open restroom, it has to benefit. It gets clean on the remote if there is a line. So like that, thermal, the virus attack with computer networks are never good, but each time the system service, actually we get injected with Covaxin or Covishield, right? So what is that? Actually, we are injecting one or other, a similar footprint of the viruses, so that our body get, our human body get prepared to attack if there is another visit, unwanted visit of by the same virus. Similarly, thermal expansion. So the blessing in disguise. So thermal expansion is often harmful and requires compensating devices, but sometimes can be used to make it strong, reliable joint without fixing a component. So what is thermal expansion? Thermal expansion means it will get extended and basic temperature rise. So it's blessing in this case is just nothing but if you have a lot of lemons, make the lemon oil. So this is the concept. So use the harmful factors to achieve a use more harmful factor to achieve a positive factor. That's what this blessing in disguise. Yeah. So thermal expansion is another example. And pneumatics to hydraulics. So this guy, he has a very convenient portable device with his hand. And suddenly if there is a line, just pop it out and it gets, you know, servers at the other end, right? And we have, I saw two case studies, but it's widely available. It's not so great. The case study one, bulletproof vest, you know, that's strong, but should not be heavy. So what is that? Material has to be strong. Okay, it has to be strong. If it is more strong, what about the density mass by one? So it should not be heavy because if I wear it, I should, you know, do certain activities. Okay, for a soldier, you know, it's very difficult for them. So I should have both, mix of both, should be strong so that there is impact of any, firing, okay, impact blow, you know, or there is a firing by the enemy country or, by the enemy. It should not penetrate, but it should be very light. So for that, how can we approach? For that, what is the solution? Let us see all the possible, let us open 13 matrix. The features, let us work out contradiction matrix, okay, and let us see 40 principles, inventory principles, 40 inventory, everybody accepted this 40 inventory principles. Let us see what 1 means, what is 26, 27, 40. All these things, you know, all these things will tell you, okay. So, really, 1 means segmentary tau, 40 means composite material, okay, and cheap, short linear. So, segmentation, copying, keep short of living, composite material. So, the solution is, you know, go for the composite material. Go for the composite material is a solution, okay? Because composite material, it's very, you know, strong, it will not heal, okay? Because of the arrangement. It's not a continuous material, it's a matrix. And it's a reinforcement agent, this reinforcement agent, you know, it's more of mechanical. If you are not able to understand, just, you know, think that composite material should be, it is strong material, but it will not heal. Okay, very strong, but it will not heal. But if I'm very strong, I'm very heavy. In general, that is the concept in mechanical materials. Composite material is opposite. I'm just a material that is strong, but it is not a heavy Okay, so we can go for carbon reinforced, you know, composites. You know, we have a lot of composites material, independent matrix reinforcement. So composite material means take this. We have matrix and then reinforcement material. Reinforcement material we give you the another case study is the how we increase the capacity of Boeing 737. Okay, so the people of this stress engineers and this master have been called by Boeing to fix issue of Boeing 737, the capacity. Capacity in the sense, without modification of anything, they take 200 passengers, they will be able to take 300 passengers. Okay, so if the weight is increased, so 200 to 300, let us say, then imagine how much fuel it has to burn per second. Okay, for that, see, fuel, all the designs are fixed. So you need to have air. So air component, you need to do something with the air. Okay, all these thoughts and visiting other field, inviting solutions, all these things, we have arrived at 17435. What is that? This corresponds to 17434 asymmetry, 7 concepts of nested dot, but we cannot do any other changes, nested dot, no, we cannot do. So what is possible? This asymmetry. So solution is this. Make this cylindrical intake, but whole engine cast. So everything remains same, even though you can see this, whenever the brake is take off, just so that the casing means the outer part. For non-engineering people, it's the outer part is asymmetry. So it used to be like this, and it has gone like this. So this shaft, everything remains same, just the casing is a slightly different. See, we cannot do a lot of modification because we need to accommodate international airport, they have the tolerance, clearance, allowances are there. Okay. So you cannot do just like that, but only possible is just to make an asymmetric case. That's it. So with this, I finish TRIS. Any doubts in TRIS? I have another half an hour time for design thinking. Any doubts? You are understanding, your understanding is clear? Please, any doubts? I email questions on TRIS now. Any doubts? At least you understand, right? TRIS means, I will tell you, you have the problem statement and we try to attempt a solution. We try to bring solution for the problem. And we will be successful in bringing a solution to the problem. But most of the time, the solution may contain certain unwanted and uninvited complexity or unanimated problem, inherent problem, unwanted, solution, unwanted, thing present in the solution. Don't be happy with that. Don't accept it rather than try to solve. Don't accept the condition, try to solve and improve. That's a five step, that is it. In nutshell, in very simple terms. Any doubts? Ma'am, anything, can I go to design thinking, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
No doubts, sir.
So, what is design thinking? So, nowadays, I am getting a lot of requests, in design thinking lecture, and I also get, I get a lot of advertisement, when you go to this design thinking course by Stanford University, particularly Stanford or Oxford University. So why is it a new topic entirely? It's not a new topic entirely. It's a old topic only. Nowadays it's getting attention, more attention because of the global employers. Because of the employers. Okay. So what is design thinking and what is it for us, for our graduates, for our internet, BBA graduates, or whatever. It's a way to connect the dots. Yes, we can have. It's a framework for innovation. Yes. Like this also, it's a framework for innovation or animation. Actually, there's a difference between innovation and animation. Okay. And the creativity at what? See, design thinking is more of a culture. People think design thinking. So there are, corporates, they are working on their job is to apply the concept of design thinking for their clients, Uber, Voila, So for their corporate, there are companies, there are four or five companies of multinational corporates. Their job is to get clients, you know, from across the engineering field, across even medical, across it, and that is they apply the concepts of design thinking. So this global employees thought, you know, instead of consulting with them, UDO, and there are like that, so many corporates are there. Instead of giving the projects to them, why don't we hire, why don't we tune our employees in design thinking, rather than going to third party and explaining to them, why don't we have this design thinking culture in our organization? So all these things we are going to cover in this design thinking. I'm repeating, what is design thinking? How to connect the dots, you know, it's a way to connect the dots. Is it a framework for innovation? It encourages you to have creativity in your workplace. Design thinking, it's like a TQM or quality enabled organization. It's like a TQM, quality enabled, it's a culture. It's a mindset. Okay? It's no more a method, it's a culture. It has to be there in their blood. Okay? It's no more a process or no more innovative techniques. No more, I mean to say, it's not no more burden to the employees. It's their everyday activity, everyday, you know, their culture. So now what else let us see in this presentation? What it offers, you know, for the graduates. Definitely it is useful, you know, because we are going to, once you graduate, definitely we are going to work for the corporates. So these corporates, you know, we are going to work for the global employees, because these employees need the culture of design thinking, you know, displayed. So that's why we need to learn what is that. So before, let us start with the design thinking. You need to familiar with certain aspects related to or directly or indirectly related to design thinking, pedagogy, andragogy, cognition, operation, big design, design strategy, empathy. Empathy is very, very important at any time. Okay? Because I have no time, so limited. So empathy is why? Empathy. See, design thinkers should have empathy, okay, in their, you know, as a culture. Okay, it should be embedded in their mind, their blood. So what is that? Empathy means understanding others' feeling. Thought. Understanding others, how others feel. How others think. What is that attitude when using their GUI? When using their graphical user interface or using their service products of, you know, so requirement of our developing communications, experience and interactions. So empathy is very important. Teachers, consultants, organization leaders, strategists and others who use design thinking. So what design thinking? I will put simply in one line. Okay. Design thinking is nothing but, okay. You should be a designer plus empathy. So design skills, empathy skills and problem solving, communication and business mindset, or how to sell the product, recalculating all this. So the integration of this. So design thinking is nothing but the following. I said this is the one, you know, one in a single line. I can fit in the definition. Okay. Entrepreneur, Bloom's taxonomy. All these things are, you know, the help, you know, to understand design thinking better. If you understand, I mean, if you remember these terms, okay. Bloom's taxonomy. I think your professors might have aware of this Bloom's taxonomy. Okay, this application of this is the creation. Okay, just remember, just read and without understanding this, remember, writing an examination. That is remember. So your professors may be able to understand this Bloom's taxonomy. So what's all about? Let us go straight. So we are in a rapidly changing world. Yes, the way the business runs or the reality changing and analytics will change. What is that? The way we are, you know, doing the business is changing. So nowadays, if I want to run a business of, you know, transporting people from one place to another place, I need to have a lot of, I need to gather, I need to be owner of fleets of vehicles. Okay. Catering to different segments of the people. SUV, luxury and ordinary. The smaller, bigger car. That was the case used to be longer. Now, you know, I don't need anything. I need to be a transporter. That's all. I need to be a cab aggregator. So, earlier, I need to have one of these taxis, just a passenger segment movement. Now, I need to have cab aggregator. I can have the app, necessary app. Okay, the app contains the process flow is like that. Those who want to drive, those who want to travel, and the payment methodology, and their location. So only four or five aspects. So the business, how we are doing the business is changing, but everything remains the same. The consumption, people, everything remains the same. And earlier I used to buy a lot of things offline. Now I used to buy. Now I habituated in buying. All. So I am remaining same. Okay, my learning capacity, everything remains same. All depends upon your education qualification and experiences. We must accept the fact that we are rapidly changing the world and consumerism. We tend to demand more in a way by product. Similarly, we tend to demand more features should be there in the product. For example, mobile is no longer a mobile number. No, it's solving most of my office purpose. So that is the demand. Customers are getting extremely, tough to deal with that. Customers are demanding extremely. So this is one aspect. Another aspect, we need to provide the products to the people. We need to provide whatever the demands, we need to provide those products to the people. So who are the people? Is you or me? I used to recite as a student a few years back. Now you guys are sitting as a student. So we are the people responsible, are the graduate people are the responsible. We are future graduates. We will be working for the global economy. So we need to prepare training of the graduates of science and engineering students is needed. So what to train? We need to train advanced technological skills, scientific and technology skills, problem solving, creative thinking, and commercialization. That's very important. So design thinking is nothing but I'm repeating what I said in previous lecture. Design thinking should be a good designer. Designer in the sense we have a lot of definition. We have the definition has evolved in what is in design. Okay. I will come to that. So you need to work, what you are supposed to work. But in the your workplace, you should think, you should have empathy. How others utilize, how others think when you offer a product or when you offer a service, how they think. Okay. Plus problem solving, plus creative thinking, plus business mind. That's what I said, business mindset, commercialization, etc. So these skills, this as a package that's called design thinking, that is demanded by the global empire. Why? Because I don't have to go and outsource this process to the company video, and there are other company. You don't have to give, you don't have to, rather you train the people itself, train the your employees itself. Okay, that's what it is. Okay. So please recognize the conventional system does not allow to think girls at any means. In this decision is proposed to this gap, but that's not only for the student, it's for the corporate entrepreneur. Corporate entrepreneurs in existing companies, critical thinking ability to the workplace. That is what demand. So global employers want their employees to be very critical, critical thinking abilities to the workplace. Okay, that's what that's see. And the products are getting, we are imagine the variety of service, variety of different variety of the features that we enjoy in the phone. Just imagine. Similarly, so the employers also, you need to be learning that you need to be very much versatile, for that only, this design thinking nowadays is getting more popular. It's a very old concept, but global employers also demanding more from the employee in order to meet the demand of their clients or the end user. So what is exact design thinking? The professional way we can define design thinking as a human-centered. Human-centered means empathy. How? When you offer a solution, when you offer certain GUI, graphic user interface, when you develop Android app or iPhone-related app, so it has to be human-centered. So human-centered means that the GUI, it has to be designed very easy and innovative, iterative. problem solving under the collaborative approach for enthralling experience, positioning product aspects. By discussing with all the stakeholders means stakeholders in the ecosystem, for example, design department, production department, quality department, all the people in the organization. Okay, no, I am not related to this. I am selling, I am selling unit or I am finance unit. I don't want to take a party or take all of this meeting. No, I will not participate on something like that. We need to give importance to them so that if there is any change, we can modify. There is any constructive criticism, there is any good feedback, let us. That's the design. So let's start the definition. We have started the definition. In essence, we should have some business mindset. That's it. So design is not what it looks like and feels. Design is how it works. So are you honest? Design is how your experience. Design is your experience. So the mechanic engineer can understand this, that design is the no more just dealing with the drawings, dealing with the parts, dealing with the their computer, and then I can sign off without discussing. No. Nowadays we need to have a design engineer, people who's working in the design. It's not what it looks like or how it feels like, it's like how it works, and it's like how it's experience, how people experience when using the product. So we need to have that business, that aspect when designing a product. So for example, I'm using this Android phone. So the designer should think how user feels when designing these products during that stage itself. So imagine the product launch and then it's getting popular and I buy. So this is the sequence. Okay, so when you design the interface itself, when you early, you need to think. Okay. So some people think design means how it looks, but of course if you dig deeper, it's really how it works and how it feels, how it experience. So design means its experience according to me. Okay. So we have three different sets: inspiration, ideation, implementation. It is of directing, divergent thinking into convergent ideal solutions. So the inspiration we have first stage, that is understand, observe and point of view. Ideation, second stage, ideate, prototype and test. Implementing storytelling, quiet and business product. So what are the theme associated? Designing being challenged, developing tangential skills, developing knowledge, seeing real life applications. So this is very important. So what's very important? This is really so we know that design thinking is important. We know the definition of design thinking. And why design thinking is important also, we know that because global employees demand the multitude of skills, they demand a lot of skills. Okay, I'm a mechanical engineer, I should be able to have some financial knowledge, I should be able to have some marketing experience, everything, for one position. Similarly, that is the demand by the global employees. Okay, global employees want, you should have all the necessary skills. Not only your technical or analytical skills, you cannot no longer survive with your technical or analytical skills. Okay. I can talk only core of mechanical engineer or any of your field of your interest or field of your graduation, but no more works. You should have some management, some things related to finance, something related to your entrepreneurship skills, product solving skills, and some commercialization techniques. So this is the demand by the global level. We have seen that, we have convinced. So what is the next, how can we approach? So what is, do we have a magic, magic band in our hand, so that tomorrow suddenly it's design thinking enabled our organization. So it's a gradual transformation. So how do we start from the leave tables at the door. So what is the leave tables at the door? I am the CEO of the organization, or I am the chairman of this, I am the owner of this business, or I am the chairman of this institution. I have all the power and I will not say I will not participate, or I will not allow others to speak their mind. All these things are strict nonsense. Leave titles. I am a professor, I am a doctor, I am a scientist, I am just a student, I am just a PM at the office. No. All the people in the stakeholders should participate. Leave, that's what I mean. Leave titles at the door. Okay, remove your titles. We are here as the stakeholders, important contributor, and how can we improve further? That should be our mantra. Okay, I encourage wild ideas, let ideas for the solutions come from different directions. Go for quantity, build on the ideas of others. Think human-centered. That's also very important. Think human-centered. So while the early when you are on the project, early when you are on the project, you should think how the users feel while using the product or service. That's very important. So when you are on the task of doing something, that's all these things are important. And repeating, no ego. In short, no ego. I am a professor, or I am a scientist, or I am an academician. And I am head of the organization, CEO, or I am just an ordinary professor or standard professor, or I am just a student, or lead titles that I do. Okay, encourage participation, okay, irrespective of your position in the organization. Okay, encourage wild ideas, go for quantity, lot of ideas, build on ideas of others, think human empathy, that's very important. How others feel when using your product as well. Be visual and make it tangible. No criticism. No, don't criticize any of the ideas. If you criticize, people will not open. Okay, people will not be participate. So don't criticize. Rather, note it down. It may work or it may not work. Let us, the more you fail yearly as often during initial stage, that's good. Failure, that's what I know I make. And that's a concept, I mean, there is a Boeing 777 on its ground, you know, because it made a lot of accidents recently. Before COVID, this Boeing 777, they did not need permission, they grounded because of the extreme pressure, you know, to perform and launch the product of this. There's some problem with their interface, chip device, they have some problem. Okay, so that's separate yesterday. Let us deal with it. Stay focused. So stay focused means what we are working, we need to be, what is the segment we want to lead to. So what is that segment, for example, everything is good, just improvement of my age, just issue of the vibration. So what's focus? So I always use global to global. The global issues into local issues. What is the local issue in your product? What is the problem? How others are feeling? What is the complaint? Okay, that is the issue. Take it out. That issue and do this exercise. What is that? You make the zero, you make the zero, you make the zero, you make the blah, 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 and so on. You just really it should be fun. Okay, it should be fun and it should not be stress. Okay. Any challenge, task complexity, any dynamics, time and constraints, empathy, walking and talking, working in a team of different capabilities, communications, native dynamics. So these are all issues. Okay. Decision-making method, commercial decision. Okay. And what's very important is the analytical thinking versus design thinking. So what is analytical thinking? So my area of topology is my area. Or fluid mechanics is my area. Or design is my area. Whatever the area of domain specific data structure, topology. So these are the areas, that is analytical thinking. Design thinking is a combination of everything, physics, mathematics, verbal, written, graphical. So data, the analytical thinking, you know, we need to state precisely. And we need to state precisely the examination point of view. So we need to state precisely. We need to arrive at the solutions precisely as always known once. So that's the data. But here the customer requirements are given. We need to generate the data, may be precise, known, unknown, visual. So there is no, that's what I said, risk and decision, there is nothing right or wrong. It's ultimately the customer. Customer's the king. Customer should be delighted. Okay. Whenever they utilize the product that you offer or the service that you offer. So solutions only one precise is expected. Design thinking, there are several answers. If my line manager is different, he or she may suggest different solutions. So skills need many analytical, and in design thinking we need to have multi-dimensional. That's what I said. We need to have technical, non-technical, financial. Okay, you should have, you should exhibit, you know, multi-phase, you know, in your work phase. That's what the demand of the global employees for the corporates. Natural thinking, conversion. And diverging, converging, creativity is limited, sky is the limit. Design thinking, your sky is the limit, creativity is endless. error penalized, you will not be getting marks if it's academic oriented, or you will not get any award or whatever. Errors are accepted, you know. Errors are learning, you know, learning is very important. So we have seen design thinking, what is the demand and how we can implement, and the difference between analytical thinking, design thinking, also we have seen. And the successful campus design thinker should exhibit the following attitude, should exhibit the following character, should have systemic vision, ability to visualize, human centered, affinity, teamwork is very important, wide access of choice, creative thinking, problem solving, mental principles, cross cultural capacities, all, you know. Lot of variety of organizations are implemented the concept of design thinking, and has resulted in improvement of profit and loss statement and profit and revenue got generated. The customer satisfaction index also got increased. So impact is very important. Expansion thinking is very important. So this is their success mantra, you know, in implementing design thinking. Okay. So you might have experienced this Google, you know, it has a great intelligence. Whenever you search, it has a really, really great intelligence. That's why Google is strong rather than other search engines, Yahoo or others. So real life exam, this is very important, guys. This is very, very important. So these are the real corporates, real, you know, everyday examples, real life examples by companies. They got, you know, consulted with the design thinking team, and the results are enormous. The results are great. Great results, the following. Profit got increased, our revenue got increased, you know, customer satisfaction got increased. They have increased the more customer database. So this is Airbnb, IBM, Impact, KT, Bank of America. So let's see, even Uber Eats also, Uber Eats, IDEO. So these are our companies. So creating future of delivery takes. So this Uber Eats, they have adapted design thinking. Nowadays even this design thinking, Uber Eats not so prevalent because of the other companies, Swiggy and Zomato. But okay, yeah. So really, this Bank of America also, they felt, you know, the number of account opening also getting very less. So they have come up with the two kinds of OD account, keep the change in person, rather than giving the change $2, $3, okay, they just transfer it to their account. Okay, in this way, they have the expense also made out, and they have the savings also. Okay, there's another design thinking example. Okay. And then Airbnb, once it was a loss-making company, and just rent your portion or you rent your home, okay, so that you know, it will accommodate, you know, its cost saving, transform Airbnb from a failing startup to $1 billion business. And then this G, this is a very funny thing, the pirate ship. Traditional analysis. This G, they have encountered a lot of problems. With this setup, not technically, it's because 80% of the kids forcefully sedated. That's not good for them. So what they have done, whatever is good for them. So if it is Indian kids, it is something different. So it's US, they have this pirate ship, and everything is there. They don't have sedate people, and they have particular kids, and they happily cooperated. Okay. So this razor blade inspiration and PNG, Procter & Gamble, we have Procter & Gamble penetrated US market enormously because they have lot everything, okay, from pad to diaper and everything, you know, this PGN they have really done great. And then this robot, this keys robot, and it gets automatically charged when it gets down. So that is the robot, automatic robot, and it cleans. And the battery gets dry, it will go automatically, gets charged. Okay. And another example, this study is published in this 2018, prosthetic human centered design and project based learning, developing mold prosthetics. So that's also an example of another design thinking. Okay, you can look into download this journal article to explore more. and this IBM BSNF, they have bought implemented design thinking and the revenue everything got increased, so on so 4.4 million transactions per day handled without any problem, 60% reduction in derailment, 50% reduction in employee injury rate. So another example, BMSF and IBM design. BMSF, it's like our IRCTC network. BMSF, it's a network, I mean railway network, transporting goods, particularly the consumer durable and non-durable goods. Okay. And IBM Siemens design thinking. So precisely starting, can you start on your own for members in office or solutions, you can have significant impact. So this is what IDEO and Cabot, GDU, these are all the companies that offer solutions of design thinking. Okay, so that's why these global employees don't want to consult them. Rather than all these things can be possible in their organizations. That's what nowadays design thinking abilities very much needed. Okay, you just I'm engineer plus manager plus sales representative, everything in one. That's what at least to appreciate what others are doing, what other skills are. And I should have design means I'm repeating. You have your own expertise in your domain field, and whenever you have expertise in your domain field, whenever you do a project, think about others, how they feel it while using your product or service. Plus problem solving, analytical, commercialization technique. Okay. Yeah, but that's what is design thinking. Okay. Any doubts? Any doubts? Any doubts? Please be free and ask questions. I'll be happy to receive questions. If there is no questions, suggest different meaning. So please ask me questions.
Students, you can ask questions by unmuting your mic, or you can post it in the chat box too.
Yeah.
Sir, we have got one question in the chat box, sir.
Yeah. Okay, I will go to that.
Sir, it is okay if you explain
it,
sir.
Yeah. See, periodic means. The pulse action is very important. The pulse action, periodic action is very important. Okay, the dots are dashes in the transmission. For example, the pulse means. I can present it. So this is what this periodic action. So it gets removed, the strain or whatever, it gets removed. So that's periodic action, and it will stop on, off, and that's what is periodic action. That's the answer to your question. Any other question?
Okay, thank you, sir.
The concentrated pressure, that's it. The concentrated pressure is the answer. Concentrated pressure removes strain or dirt, that's it. Any other questions? You can type here, you can type. I may not be able to hear you properly, so you can type in the chat box.
Students, if you have any doubt or any questions in the chat box, or you can join the session. Okay, sir. No doubt.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you for the opportunity, ma'am. Thanks. I learned a lot.
Wait, sir. We will finish it up. Thank you, Dr. Srinivasan Narayan, sir, for your valuable speech. Being thankful and expressing your gratitude is an important part of being happy in life. I now request Dr. S. Malathi, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, to propose the word of thanks.
Whether it does mean to us, I feel privileged for providing me this opportunity to thank all the dignitaries. On the behalf of IIC of Ayman College, I would like to express my gratitude to esteemed delegates of today's program for their presence and contribution to make this Impact Lecture Series 2 a great grand success. On behalf of Ayman College, we thank Ministry of Education Innovation Cells, AICT, for funding to conduct Impact Lecture Series. Also, I would like to thank our respected director, sir, Dr. Raymond Chalamit, respected principal, ma'am, Dr. Sudarshini Ayanas, IIC counselor of our Ayman College, for providing immense support to make this event successful. I would like to deliver my special thanks to our today's chief guest, Dr. Srinivasan Narayan, for providing time for this busy schedule to grace the event. Thank you, sir. Also, I extended my heartfelt thanks to Mrs. Sarha, IIC coordinator and assistant professor of English, for the time and hard work to make this event successful. Also, I would like to thank Ms. Majita, system administrator, for providing technical support for this throughout the program. I congratulate all the participants for their active participation. Thank you. Thank you to all. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Unity is strength. When there is teamwork and collaboration, wonderful things can be achieved. I really thank everybody for attending the meeting peacefully and patiently. Thank you all. Thank you, sir.
Gracias.